So it's opening now. Oh, yeah, it's Visual Studio. Then I will open the new folder. Wait. In that we have web designing, I think. Yeah, web designing. Okay, then next I will create this one. I will continue that. It's print, right? Okay, it's from prompt, right? Okay, so I need a heading part. It has to in that I need to H2 and tag that I have to write delete record. So I need a button in that HTML button. So I will write the button name is delete, and I will use inside the button its event is on click event. And name of the event, I will if I write any of that function inside that, then it's delete click. Okay, so next I need to be write inside the script language JavaScript. Inside the script we are using MIME type. It's like type equal text by JavaScript. Okay, so I need a paragraph after that button. It's paragraph. Inside the paragraph, I will give a ID, particular ID. It's message. Message is my particular ID inside the button. It's a ptag. It's paragraph. Okay. So next thing is, I need write the function delete click. Function delete click. Okay, so when delete click you fire up, when I click the delete button, the delete click like function will fire up. Okay, so I need to be assign that particular value, the ptag, by using ID. Okay, so at first I need to be write a prompt x equal confirm. Inside that record inserted. Record will be okay. I will using delete click, so if I write delete also, it's better. Record will be deleted. Okay, done. So next thing I require, by using like ID, I will assign that value in the particular variable msg, and I will document dot get element by ID, get element by ID, and ID name is msg. Okay, so next thing, it will be assigned whatever value will be that in the msg. MSG is a variable. Okay, so I will write a condition in the inside that if else condition, if x equal true. What is true? I will define I will show you that one. What is true and what is false value? In that before I will tell you that one in that control in prompt and in alt we have some functionality happening in that. If I click OK button, it will be true, and if I cancel that, click the cancel button, it will be false. So that one I will show you. Okay. So if x equal true. So first thing I require msg. MSG is my variable. I will assign that value of that msg by using id. Okay, msg is inner text. Font. Color, it's red or anything you want. If I give red inside that, you have to use not double quotation, it's single quotation you need to use inside that, because that previously we are using in the parent element we are using double quotation. That's why in the child element we need to be write that single quotation. Okay, so next thing I require, so record dated. Record deleted. Okay, and font, and then so if my condition is false, as msg dot inner html. Okay, inside we need to write font color, font color green. Okay, I will write the single quotation inside that, and this one is the cancel. Okay, font close and double quotation inside that. Okay, then so I'll open that one in that live server, then I will show you. What happening in that situation? In that confirm, it will be show me in that two option in that, it's okay and cancel. When I click okay button, it will be show me that is record deleted. And if I click cancel button, it will be right canceled. Okay. Let's see. Delete button is there. When I click delete button, it will fire out. Record will be deleted. When I click OK button, it will be record deleted. Okay. When I click cancel, it will be show me in that cancel. I hope you understand how I use two value is that in that. Yes, when you confirm that button, it will be true value, and when you cancel that, it is a false value. Okay. And what is the difference between inner text and inner HTML? I will show you that one also. When I click that OK button, it will be show me all font color red, whatever write inside that inner text, it will be show me in that format. But in the inner HTML, it not show me in that font color green, all these things. It only show me in that cancel, because in inner text, inner HTML, you can write any of the HTML element, any of the HTML text. But by using that inner text, only you can write any plain text inside that. Okay, you cannot write any of that font color red or background color or any of that property you cannot write inside that. Okay, this is the difference between inner HTML and inner text. I hope you understand. and you got decent idea about like what is like condition and how it's work and how if I click the OK button and if I go click the cancel button, what happen? I hope you understand. If any doubt, you can ask me. Any doubt, guys?
No, sir.
Okay, thank you so much. So next thing we have to discuss like variable, data type, and operator, statement, and function. At first, we need to be discuss variable. So what is variable? So variable are simply a storage location in the memory when you can store a value and use it an expression. Okay, so variable is a simply like storage location, and in that storage location means it is a memory. In that memory, you can store a value inside that, and it will be used in the any expression you are using inside that particular coding part. Okay, so variable configuration is in that three part. That is like declaration variable, declaration part, and rendering or assigning part, and initialization part. So what is declaration, what is rendering in assign, and what is initialization, we have to discuss. Okay, wait, I will open that paint, then I will show you what is declaration and what is assigning or rendering, what is initialization. And next we have to discuss like what is the difference between variable and like let and constant keyword. Okay, so first thing is that so declaration, we have a config variable config, yeah, in the three stages. First one is declaration. Okay, so its example is variable A. Okay, this is the declaration part. Second one is we have rendering and assign. Okay, example is that A equal 5. Okay, this is A equal 5. So next thing is last one, not least, it's initialization. Initialization. So example is that variable A equal 6. So this is the declaration and rendering, assigning, and initialization. So declaration is define the name of the variable and specify its scope. Okay, have you got to that? I will in the declaration I will write in the name of that variable. Its A is the name of the variable, and the value is 5 or like 6, the value. Okay, so in the rendering, assigning the value in it, you need to be use assigning that. If you want to if you assign a particular value to the A, then you have to call it like declaration is like assigning or rendering. Okay, if you write like variable A equal to 5 or A equal to 6, this is initialization. Initialization is assigning the value into the variable at the time of declaration. Okay, means like declaration plus assigning is initialization. Okay, like in a declaration we have to define the name of the variable, and in that assigning we have to assign a particular value to the variable, and initialization we have to declare the with declaration we are in a, like assigning the value to the variable. Okay, this is the difference between declaration and rendering and initialization. Okay, so JavaScript variable can be used without declaration if JavaScript not in the strict mode. So one thing is that if you are not using JavaScript in the strict mode, like use strict, so without declaring the variable we can use any you can use any of the variable, and we can assign in the any of the particular value inside that, okay, without declaring the variable. If you use the particularly use strict mode, we cannot do that, okay? So directly you can render a value and use the value also. Means a equal to 5 you can use without, if we are not using the strict mode, okay? Next we have to discuss what is the difference between variable, let and constructor. Okay, yeah
sir, ye jo declaration hai usme ye bhi dena zaruri hota hai, variable
hai. Aapka awaaz theek se nahi aa raha hai, aapka awaaz theek se.
सर मैं कह रही हूँ कि जो डिक्लेरेशन है उसमें हमें टाइप देना भी जरूरी होता है क्या?
कौन सा टाइप? ये वाला, वेट, कौन सा टाइप? वेरिएबल बोल रहे हो?
यस सर, जैसे डिक्लेयर किया हमने किसी भी वेरिएबल को या फिर कांस्टेंट को, तो उसमें हमें टाइप होता है.
हाँ देना होता है, बट अगर स्ट्रिक मोड, जावास्क्रिप्ट एक स्ट्रॉन्गली टाइप लैंग्वेज नहीं है, अगर आप यूज नहीं करते तो आपका कोई दिक्कत नहीं होता, बट अगर आपका जैसे कि यूज स्ट्रिक मोड यूज करते हैं तो आपको देना पड़ता है वेरिएबल या कांस्टेंट और लेट एनी ऑफ दैट.
ओके
ओके, थैंक यू सो मच. एनीवन हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी गाइस, बिकॉज दिस इज ए मेन पार्ट वी हैव टू डिस्कस, बिकॉज एवरी in the coding part we have to use variable declaration like as initialization. So let's see what is the keyword is there in the variable, JavaScript variable keyword. So what is the difference between that? Wait, I will divide into three parts, then I will show you one by one. Okay, so first thing we have to discuss variable, its keyword is var. Okay, so first thing is that it allow declaration, it allow declaring, rendering or assigning, rendering and initialization. Okay, so it allow declaration, rendering and initialization also. Next in that, it is a function scope variable. I will show you in the practically how it's work also. You have to understand theory part at first, then I will show you practically. Okay, so it is function scope variable. So what is function scope variable? I will show you in that practically, but if I talk in that theory part, function scope variable means inside the function you have to write any of the declaration and like rendering and installation in the any block, but you have to write inside the function. This is the function scope variable. What is block scope variable? Block scope variable means in that function we have many blocks, block is there, whatever you have to write in that curly braces it will be block. Okay, so if it is a block scope variable, if you declare a variable inside the block and you want to access outside of the block, it not allowed to access the particular value. In the function scope variable, if I using that power function inside like function inside the function, if I declare or initialize or like rendering a value and I want to access the particular value outside of that, may not be allowed. Okay, so let's see, I will show you that one how it's work, then you have to understand better what is function scope variable and what is block scope variable. Okay, so you can declare in any block of function. Okay, function. Then third thing is that it allows So what is shadowing? You may be listen that name is partly like a different name. So what is the shadowing process? Shadowing is the process of redeclaring and redefining the some name of the variable within the scope. Okay. So I will show you in the practically also what is shadowing and why like variable allows shadowing and like other keyword is not allowing shadowing. I will show you in that practically also. Okay. But before that, you need to understand what is shadowing in the theory part. Then you have to understand in the practical also. Okay. So shadowing is the process of redeclaring and redefining some same space. Same name variable. Bit in the scope. Okay. The scope means it's function scope or like block scope, whatever. Okay. So next thing is it allow hoisting. So what is hoisting? It allow hoisting. STRNG hoisting. Okay. So what is hoisting? It is the process that declaration of variable at first using rendering. I will show you practically what is hoisting also. Hoisting means if I like use that value, I will not declare the value in that firstly. I will use the value and print the value, then I will declare the value like after that. This is the hoisting. You have to understand practically better, I think. So this is the variable. So what is let keyword and constant? We have to discuss. Wait, I will mark this one. It's variable. It's variable. Okay, done. So this is variable. Next we have to discuss let keyword. So next thing is let. This is a keyword. Okay, you have to understand this is a keyword. So first is it allow declaring, rendering and initialization. Okay. Next thing is it allow only block scope variable. Okay. Block scope variable. So what is like block scope variable? It only accessible within the defined block. This is the block scope variable. Okay. So next thing is not allow hoisting. Okay. So next thing is like fourth part is not allow shadowing. Okay. This is the let keyword. Next we have to discuss constant. Okay. Wait. We have constant. Okay. So first thing is that it defines in using const keyword const. Okay. It is a block scope variable. block scope variable. So next thing is it cannot be redefined. This shadowing not allowed. Okay, wait. It cannot be. Redefined. Okay. So next thing is not allowed. Fourth one is it not allow shadowing. Shadowing from hoisting and declaring and rendering or assigning the value. It only allow initialization. Okay, you have to understand it allow declaring, rendering and initialization, but it not allow rendering and declaring, only allow initialization. Okay, I will show in practically also how it's work. Wait. Okay. I will create another file inside that. It's variable or like keyword. Okay, I will create another file in that JS. I will create, okay, like keyword dot HTML. Okay. So this one is that keyword. Okay. So next we have to discuss it allow like shadowing rendering, assigning, or like initialization, it allow or not. Then we have to discuss shadowing, all these things. Okay. So at first, I need to be use tick mode inside that. I need to be create another JS file, and I will link that one in that HTML. Okay. Wait. I will create another file inside that. It's keyword. Keyword. Dot JS. Okay. I need to link that file inside that script src dot slash like JS. Inside we have keyword dot JS. Okay, and like mime type is like text JavaScript. Okay, done. So next I will show you that one how it's allowed. So I need to be used a strict mode inside that. So use strict. Okay. So I need to be create a function inside that. Function. The fun is my function. Okay. I need to be called the function. F1. Okay. Then. Whatever I write inside that, and I will not when I need that access the particular value, I can access by call that function. Okay, so wait, I will connect my charger. Yeah, done. So first one is I will variable x equal 10. Okay, so it is an initialization. This is an initialization. Wait, I will write inside that initialization. Okay. Next one, if I will write a condition inside that x equal 10, वेरिएबल y, this is a declaration. This is a declaration declaring a variable, okay, and I need to be assigning a particular it's rendering or assigning a particular value inside that. So y equal 20, okay. This one is the block, okay, and this one is the function. Wait, I will show you. This one is a function. So this one is the block scope variable, and this one is the function scope variable. Function scope variable means whenever you have to write any of that particular variable inside that, okay, you have to write like any of the block, and you can access outside of the block. Okay, this is the block. If I write another block inside that, it allow. Block scope variable means, I will show you later how it's work. Okay. So if I access a particular value by using document.write, right, and I need to be x equal x, and next thing I require y equal, this string I need to be right inside that. And this is the value, I want to access the x value and y value also. So I need to write y. Okay, done. I need to be open in live server. So inside that, have you observed I will using initialization declaration and also assigning or rendering the value. So it's allow. Rendering or assigning the value also, okay. Well, it's opening now. Have you heard that one? It's x equal to 10 and y equal to 20, okay.
सर y को कैसे एक्सेस कर लें, ये तो बाहर है ना ब्लॉक से.
हाँ, ये जो है वेरिएबल, हाँ मैं बता रहा हूँ, वेरिएबल एक फंक्शन स्कोप वेरिएबल है, ओके. ये फंक्शन स्कोप है, अगर हम लेट यूज करते हैं इनसाइड दैट तो हम एक्सेस नहीं कर पाते, क्योंकि लेट एक जैसे कि ब्लॉक स्कोप वेरिएबल है, ब्लॉक के बाहर हम एक्सेस नहीं कर सकते. बट ये जो है फंक्शन स्कोप वेरिएबल है, इसलिए हम एक्सेस कर पाए.
अच्छा, भेड़ जो है वो पूरे फंक्शन में कहीं भी वो एक्सेस कर सकते हैं.
पूरे फंक्शन में, अगर ये देखो, ये एक ब्लॉक है मेरा फर्स्ट ब्लॉक, ये सेकंड ब्लॉक है. फर्स्ट ब्लॉक में मैंने 10 जैसे कि असाइन किया वैल्यू, और सेकंड में क्या मैंने वाई वैल्यू को असाइन किया. अगर एक्स इक्वल 10 होता है तो यहाँ आएगा वो, ओके. एक्स अगर 10 हो गया, 9 हो गया, तो यहाँ नहीं आएगा, ये फॉल्स हो जाएगा, ओके. ये जो बॉक्स के अंदर कभी एंटर करेगा वो, अगर एक्स इक्वल 10 हुआ तो. ये अलग बात है, हम डिस्कस करेंगे कंडीशन में. बट ये जो है वेरिएबल एक्स फंक्शन को वेरिएबल है, इसलिए वो प्रिंट करा और एक्सेस कर पाए हम. अगर ये हम लेट के कीवर्ड यूज करते हैं तो ये एक्सेस नहीं होता. आई विल शो यू दैट वन आल्सो, ओके.
ओके ओके, थैंक यू सर. ओके,
सो आई विल शो यू दैट वन, लाइक हाउ इट कैन नॉट अलाउ इन दैट लेट कीवर्ड. लेट्स सी इफ आई यूजिंग इनसाइड दैट लेट, ओके, एंड दिस वन इज आल्सो लेट. If I want to access that particular value, it's not allowed to access the particular value, because I want to access that another block scope variable, that's why it's not allowed, okay. What is the error is that, I will show you that one. Next I will resolve that error, whatever error is there. So yeah, inside that we have why is not defined. Have you heard that one? Why is not defined? Wait, I will show you. Why is not defined? Because we are not accessing the particular value inside that, accessing the value inside the block. That's why it show me in that format, like why is not defined. If I using that one, I want to access inside that block, inside the block, it allow, but it show me another error, because what the error? It printed, okay, x equal to 10. And y equal to 20. Okay, this is a block variable. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड गाइस व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन लेट कीवर्ड एंड वेरिएबल. वेरिएबल इज ए फंक्शन स्कोप वेरिएबल, फंक्शन स्कोप एंड लेट इज ए लाइक ब्लॉक स्कोप वेरिएबल. इफ आई राइट अनदर ब्लॉक इफ आई वांट टू एक्सेस द पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू इन दैट लाइक फर्स्ट ब्लॉक देन इट वी कैनॉट डू दैट बिकॉज दिस इज ए ब्लॉक स्कोप वेरिएबल. ओके एंड वन थिंग इज दैट if I using constant inside that constant and this one is a constant, it's not allowed. Missing initialization in the constant variable, constant declaration. Okay, it so mean that it only allow initialization, not allow declaration as well as rendering or as well as assignment. It only allow initialization. This is the initialization I will use inside that is like what is that declaration and like rendering. Okay, if I use that particularly y equal to 20, let's print me all this in like x equal to 10 and y equal to 20. Okay, so this is the difference between variable and let and constant. Someone allow declaration, declaration installation and rendering, but constant not allow declaring, declaring and rendering, only allow installation. I hope you understand what is the difference between that. And second thing is that we have to discuss what is hoisting and shadowing also. Okay, wait. Okay. So I will show you shadowing option. Next, I will show you that hoisting option. Okay. So shadowing. Wait. Yeah. Then, so first thing is require variable. I need to be define the variable also at first. Then I will show you that get key. Okay. So if I write again, why I want to assigning new value inside that variable y. And I want to access that particularly in that outside of the block. It's a function scope variable. That's fine. Right. So y and y equal 30. Okay. Let's see. It's printed or not. It's printed fine. Y equal to 30. Okay. If I using like let keyword inside that. This one is the let and this one is the let also and this one is let. Okay, I want to assigning a new value inside that and the document dot write I need to write inside the block because it's a block scope variable. Okay, so it so mean that y is already been declared, so that's why variable is allowing redeclaring or initialization means it's hoisting, it's shadowing, and but let keyword is not allowing shadowing. This is the difference between constant let and variable. Okay, if I using like constant inside that, it's not allowed because it's not allowed declaration and rendering. So if I initialize a new value inside that, not allowed. So that's why it not allows shadowing, hoisting, and also declaring and rendering. Okay. Next, we have to discuss what is hoisting. Let's see. So hoisting, I will show you that one. Wait. X equal 10. If I write document dot write inside, if I write any of that, I want to access the particular value X document dot write. Okay, but have you observed that one? I will not declare the variable inside like at first. If I declare the value at last also, it finds the particular value. Wait, what happened? Yeah, I use let keyword or like even this variable. Okay, wait, I will check what happened. Document dot write. I think it's problem with that. X is defined, is not defined, wait. Yeah, it's printed now. Have you observed that one? Okay. So if I use let keyword inside that, let, it's not allowed. Okay. So this is the difference between, this is the process, is hoisting process. Okay. At first, I need to be assign the value. And after that, I will access the value, and in the next part, I want to declare the variable. So it only possible in that variable, not in constant or not in let keyword. Okay, this is the cannot access the X before initialization. Okay, so this is the difference between let keyword and like constant and variable. If any doubt, you can ask me. Then I will show you what is global variable. Okay, so any doubt in that, like variable, let, or like constant, you can ask me in chat box. Okay, anyone have any doubt, guys? Okay. So one thing is that we have naming variable naming. So what is variable naming? Variable naming means we have if I want to access the particular variable, like naming is like if I using number, or inside that text, or inside that any of the special character, it allow or not, we have to discuss. And what is global scope variable, I will show you. So what is global scope variable means, if you want to access the particular globally, then you have to access, write the variable outside of the function, a equal to 5. Okay. Then you have to access outside of the function, inside of the function, whatever you need. It's right. It's right and a. Okay, 5 is printed. So any block of the function, this is the global variable. Okay. So next thing we have to discuss naming of the variable. Okay. So what is naming of the variable and when we are using that naming of the variable, and if the naming of the variable means in the variable I will assigning a value is 5 inside that a is the variable name. So in the variable we cannot write any of that number at the first and any special character in between that. I will show you that one, how you are right. So if I write 2021 and it's variable naming is 2021 and name, it's not valid. Okay, valid naming. If I use underscore, we report that variable name, it's a valid one. Okay. If I using name also, it's a value. It's like text at first, name. And after that, if I use 2021, it's also valid. So variable cannot contain period in that बट इट्स नॉट डॉट, इट कैन नॉट बी मोर देन 255 कैरेक्टर, इट्स 255 कैरेक्टर, ओके, दिस इज द स्ट्रिक्ट लाइक मोड, इट्स 25 आफ्टर 25 कैरेक्टर इट्स नॉट अलाउड, यू हैव टू राइट इन बिटवीन दैट 250 कैरेक्टर 255 कैरेक्टर, ओके, एंड ऑलवेज फॉलो दैट कैम्बल केस नेमिंग. व्हाट इज कैम्बल केस नेमिंग इज दैट Campbell case naming is that txt name means inside the heavy object that txt is that lowercase letter and name is that in that first letter will be in the capital. So this is the name, like Campbell case letter. Okay, it's like txt password. Okay, so you have to write Campbell case writing any of that you have to. Write variable naming inside that. So if you write like a number or like any of the special character before that name, it not allowed. You have if you write if you want to write something number inside that, then you have to write before its underscore. Okay. I hope you understand. If any doubt, you can ask me. In JavaScript, we have discussed variable, and we in that let and constant, and in that. It's like global variable, and what is the naming or variable naming, and how we are using that name inside that like variable, and what is that like valid variable name, and how many character it allow? It's 250 character, 255. Sorry, it's 255 character and txt name, and like you have to write Campbell case. Okay. Any doubt? You can ask me in chat box.
रेंडरिंग का मतलब
ये होता है कि अगर कोई भी वैल्यू आप अगर एक वेरिएबल का नेमिंग में असाइनिंग करते हैं, जो असाइनिंग बोलते हैं वही रेंडरिंग होता है. ओके, ए इक्वल टू 5 मींस इट रेंडरिंग टू दैट, लाइक 5 इज रेंडरिंग टू द ए और असाइनिंग टू द ए. ओके, सेम असाइनिंग और रेंडरिंग एक ही लाइक डेफिनेशन होता है. Okay, thank you sir. Anyone guys? So tomorrow session we have to discuss what is data type and we have primitive data type. We have non-primitive data type. So in the non-primitive data type we have to discuss number, string, boolean, and null and undefined. So in the non-primitive data type, we have to discuss array, object, and regular expression. I already told you regular expression. I don't need to explain again. Okay. I will give you like a practical example. So how we can use the regular expression in that like login form or like password form. Means when I enter like password, it will be follow the pattern. And when like user not enter to the particular pattern inside that password, then it not allowed to login or not allowed to register that. So you have to discuss the regular expression. At first, we have to discuss what is number, but like string and boolean, null, undefined, and how we can use that one. And we have to discuss array. What is array? How can you like insert a value inside the array, and we can delete a value inside the array, and how we can access a particular value inside the array. Okay. So any doubt you can ask me, then if no doubt you can leave your attendance in chat box. Yeah, thank you so much for attending the class, and thank you for your listening me, and have a good day. Bye.
Okay,
thank you,
sir.
Thank you so much.